talked about what we were going to do today, but we didn't preordain this particular routine, if you will. So they're doing wonderful at being receptive and not knowing what's coming next. So this is 8 counts of both hands flip, and 8 counts of both hands slash. Ready? 5, 6, ready, and go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Good. Switch, please. Switch. Alright, now the next thing we did was we took the gesture of dab, which is a more direct gesture, and we added weight to it so it became punch. So let's do 8 counts of dab and then add weight to it so it becomes punch for 8 counts. So I got that? Are you close? 5, 6.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Very good. And so the biggest discussion was not just about movement then, it was about what sounds do those gestures look like? What sound are we asking from the ensemble based on how we're moving through space? And so ultimately, these rhythmic gestures, you can realize, are variations of staccato, marcato, or clear articulation. We then got into expressive gestures, which the four expressive gestures are float, glide, press, and ring. And so for legato conducting, these are the types of gestures we would use in those environments. Can you guys do 4 counts right, 4 counts left, 4 counts together of float? 5, 6, 5, 6, float. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. Remember that this isn't rhythmic. We don't want to see a clear pop. This has to be a very smooth, sustained motion in the wrist. Yes? Good. All right, cool. Let's do this now. I didn't ask you to do this before. Would you do 8 counts of growing float and 8 counts of decreasing float? So bigger as we go, and then softer as we go. 8 counts of 8 counts now. Float. Both feet. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. So the reality is that you've noticed we haven't conducted a beat pattern yet, right? Nor did we at the beginning of this camp. Because it's more important that the students know how to demonstrate different styles in their gesture. The architecture of the pattern with where the beats are located is, we can teach that to anybody. It's more important that they learn how to change style from one to the other, and then figure out where do I place the beats, so that we don't get